I'm with Natalie Chan in her Parnell showroom. Natalie, how are you?
I'm good, thank you. How are you?
I'm good, thank you. This is a fantastic space you've got here.
No, it's fantastic. It's a colourful place, and it's just basically the whole room's filled up with my own inspirations of everything and bits and pieces and things that I just love.
Now, I noticed that you're wearing a fascinator, and it's as day wear.
Yes.
It's very brave of you.
I don't think it's brave. I just think it's just my personality coming out. And without forgetting that in the 1950s, a lot of women wore it, and it was a daily sort of accessory that they were expected to wear. And it's just a bit of me that wants to bring that back out again.
And you're trying to bring that out with your clients too?
Oh, absolutely. I always encourage them, you know, when they get their headwear made, that it's not just to wear for the, you know, the outfit they're getting it for, but to encourage them to wear it at other times as well.
You hear some women say, I'm not a hat person. Do you think this is true, or do you think that there's a hat for everyone?
I think there's a hat for everyone. I mean, I do fascinators and headwear, so it's a bit different because hats got brims on them. But everybody's all different, and I don't know, it just depends on the person's style and whether they want to wear one, and that makes a difference in itself.
And in recent years there's been a bit of renaissance for hats and fascinators. Mm-hmm. Do you think that Kiwi women are embracing that?
I think so. I think with races, it definitely encourages a lot of women to go outside and wear it, and then when they do pop it on, they realize how gorgeous they feel and how beautiful they look and how timeless it is. That, again, I try and get them to do it in the daytime as well, or if not, they can save it for another special event to wear, and I think there is quite a huge market for it.
Behind, this is your summer collection.
Yes.
Behind us. Do you want to talk me through and tell me, you know, what's behind it, really?
I divide them up into different categories. So I've got my bridal sort of wear. Admittedly, this doesn't really change all that much due to because with bridal sort of things are quite traditional. Then I've got my evening sort of cocktail ones that are a bit more black because a lot of women do wear a lot of black. And so that matches most of their outfits, or if not, it'll be part of their accessories. And then I've got my colored ones that also evening cocktail and also possibly for the day. And some women wear something like this in the silk flower one. Sometimes it's like a big brooch or corsage, and I think it looks absolutely amazing. And well, like me, I wear my headpiece as well. So some of these are the colored ones you can do it, and I do show them how to dress it up and dress it down with. And I guess my inspiration is always going to be the same. It's going to be romantic. It's going to be vintage inspired, very 1950s. And I guess, you know, I do follow a fashion sort of trend as well. And currently, it is one of the hotter things at the moment.
Like you say, though, you can, I guess, wear these in so many different ways.
And you can kind of do anything, depending on your hairstyle. And, of course, you might be a bit limited when it comes to shorter hair, but you can still, you know, make do. And then normally with headpieces, the closer to you wear it to the crown of your head is the more sort of like kind of higher fashion, and also you want to be noticed, you're not a wallflower. And then that's great to wear for the races or going to weddings. And then if you want to be a little bit more demure and going to like bars and restaurants or going for a nice dinner somewhere, you can always wear it back of your head, and that kind of dresses it down, because then that doesn't become the focus of attention as you would going to the races.
How much bling can you get away with wearing when you've got one of these fancies on?
Oh, you can have anything. I mean, that's like how long is a piece of string? Totally as much as you want. I sometimes cover some of them with, I don't know whether you call sequins bling, because it catches like the light and the sun.
No, I'm talking about the Christmas tree look. I mean, how much? I mean, some of these jump out at you more than others in terms of embellishment. So maybe what I'm saying is, should you wear less jewellery with, say, this one than you would with that, which is a bit simpler?
I think that all comes down to personal style. I mean, admittedly, you do start looking a bit more like a Christmas tree when you have something quite big and, you know, gorgeous and avant-garde and haute couture, but if you match it up with a big, chunky, big bling necklace, but again,
You could pull it off.
People do it. I mean, you do see it in fashion runway shows, but however, again,
you need the personality.
You totally need the personality and the confidence as well, because anything can look gorgeous when you're confident.
So Natalie, you're going to show me how to put together two looks, day and evening.
Yeah, yes I am, most definitely.
Okay, let's go and take a look. Okay Natalie, so tell me about this look, which I'm really enjoying. Tell me how you came up with this.
Right, so when I was saying about doing hair fasteners and how you can wear it in the daytime, this is more my day look. So you can, well, not pull out any old dress, but because my look is quite 1950s, the cut of the dress is quite 1950s, and we modernize it by putting the beautiful crystal jandals that I got, well, sandals from Mi Piace. And then we team that whole look because we're going with the gold that matches the dress. And then the headwear, again, with the whole color, I think it's more daytime. And then putting it closer to your head and to the front of the crown, I think it just pulls the look out just beautifully.
Well, how you came up with this
little idea? Actually, that one's been featured in Simply You, and I kind of aimed it more towards the races and also more the daytime. And again, with the color, I just think it's just one of those old vintage sort of like pea green that I love so much. And then you've got a mix of like my handmade rosettes with double-sided satin, some gorgeous feathering that I have, just as little wind ticklers, and just put a little ensemble together. Yeah, that's basically how I've created it.
Well, this look, it really makes me feel like a lady.
And this is probably more the evening cocktail, lady-like sort of outfit. And keeping it into the same dress, we've just swapped the headpiece to more with a, you know, beautiful silk silk rosette with your veiling, which is quite nice in the evening. And then you've got your beautiful feathers just kind of coming out from it. Again, little wind ticklers. And then again, changing the accessory, like putting on a beautiful silk satin bow as well to make it like a little clincher on your waist, which is the smallest part of the body of a female. And then change your shoes and some beautiful Pinto satin pumps, which is again, beautiful Mi Piace ones. And it just basically alters the look quite differently as your first daytime look.
Thank you very much. It's been a lot of fun.
Not a problem. Glad you enjoyed it.
Well, I hope you've got some ideas and inspiration from these talented hatters. That's all from me. Happy hat hunting.